जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी
I'm not afraid. Yeah. 悲伤，与此同时，遵守着成熟时间的指令， 那个猎人小心翼翼地藏在远处，射出了他的箭，这射穿了苦林的鸟的躯体，并杀死了他。
There is no purport. We'll go on and read text 57.
这个时节没有要旨，所以我们继续读下一个时节第五十七节。
Evam yoyam apashyantya atmapayam abhutayaha nainam rakshyata shodshyantya patimvaksha shatet api. Translation. Thus Yamaraj, in the guise of a small boy,told all the queens, you are all so foolish that you lament, but do not see your own death. Afflicted by a poor fund of knowledge, you do not know that even if you lament for your dead husband for hundreds of years, you will never get him back alive, and in the meantime, your lives will be finished.
译文：于是 Yamaraj 装扮成一个小男孩的样子，告诉所有的王后们，你们所有的人都是如此的愚蠢，以至于你们在悲伤，但是却看不到你们自己的死亡，受到缺乏知识之苦。你们并不了解，即使你们为你们死去的丈夫悲哀上上百年，你们永远也不能让他再活过来了，而与此同时，你们的生命也将终结。
Purport by Srila Prabhupada. Yamaraj once asked Maharaj Yudhisthira, what is the most wonderful thing within this world? Maharaj Yudhisthira replied, Ahani ahani bhutani gacchanti ha yamalayam shesha stavaram ichanti kim ascharyam mataparam.Hundreds and thousands of living entities meet death at every moment, but a foolish living being nonetheless thinks himself deathless and does not prepare for death. This is the most wonderful thing in this world. Everyone has to die because everyone is fully under the control of material nature.Yet everyone thinks that he is independent, that whatever he likes he can do, that he will never meet death, but live forever, and so on. So-called scientists are making various plans to which living entities in the future can live forever. But while they are thus pursuing such scientific knowledge,Yamaraj, in due course of time, will take them away from their business of so-called research.
要旨 Yamaraj 曾经有一次问 Maharaj Yudhisthira, 在这个世界上最令人惊奇的事情是什么? Maharaj Yudhisthira 回答道 Ahandi ahandi bhutani gacchanti ha yamalayamSheshastha param ichamti kingmascharyam ataparam 成百上千的生物体每时每刻都在跟死亡相见，但是一个愚蠢的生物体却仍然认为他自己是不死的，并且不去为死亡做任何准备。这就是在这个世界之内最令人惊奇的事情。每一个人都要死，因为每一个人完全都在物质自然的控制之下，然而每一个人却认为他是独立的，无论他想做什么他都可以做，而且呢他永远不会遇见死亡，而是永恒的生活下去等等。所谓的科学家们造出各种各样的计划，通过这些计划生物体们在未来可以永恒的生活下去，但是当他们就这样在追求这种科学知识的时候， Yamaraj 随着时间的流逝将把他们从他们所谓的研究的事业之中带走。
Om Ajnanatimarandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chatsuru Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Vancha Kaupata Rubyascha Kripa Sindhupayeva Cha Patitanam Bhavanibhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So Hiranyakashipu wanted to pacify the family members because Hiranyaksha had been killed. So he was speaking this narration, he was telling them about incidents from the past.
Hiranyakashipu 想安慰他的家庭成员，因为他的兄弟 Hiranyaksha 被杀了，所以他就给大家讲了一个过去的故事。
And he told them this one story about how one time a great king was killed in battle, and the king had many queens, and all of his wives were naturally lamenting the death of their husband.
他讲了这样的一个故事，一个国王在战场上战死被杀了，而他所有的王后们都在为这个国王的去世而悲伤。
And they did not even want to see the body of their husband cremated.
他们甚至不想看到他们的丈夫的尸体被火化。
So, Yamaraj came in the form of a small boy to talk to the queens.
于是 Yamaraj 把自己装扮成一个小男孩的样子来跟这些王后们讲话。
He took the form of a small boy because people tend to be more prone to hear from young children, especially if the young child can speak some philosophy.
他把自己打扮成一个小男孩的样子，是人们倾向于去听小孩的话，尤其是这个小孩呢能够讲出一些哲学。
So the Yamaraj, in the form of a small boy, came to talk to the queens to.Enlighten them about the nature of the material body.
于是 Yamaraj 以一个小男孩的样子出现在这些王后们面前，给他们讲述关于这个躯体的本性。
And he wants to let them know about the danger which they face, that they themselves one day are going to have to die.
他想让他们了解到他们自己所要面临的危险，因为他们自己终于有一天也会死。
So Yamaraj had told the story about the Kalinga bird, how there were two birds, a male and a female bird, and the female bird got caught in the net, and the male bird was lamenting for his wife.
于是他讲述了这个 Kalinga 鸟的故事。这个雌鸟呢被猎人抓在网里，而这个公鸟呢就在为雌鸟而悲伤。
So.The male bird was lamenting. While he was lamenting, at that time the hunter came, shot an arrow, and killed him.
公鸟在悲伤的时候，猎人来了，向他射了一支箭，杀了他。
And in this way, Yamaraj, in the form of a small boy, is warning the queens that you have to think about your own life.
Yamaraj 以一个小男孩的样子，就在警告这些王后们：你们也要小心你们自己的生活。
Your husband's dead, and nothing you can do will bring him back to life.
你们的丈夫已经死了，你们无能为力，没有办法让他复活。
But now you have to think about your own life.
现在你们要考虑一下自己的生活。
And yet, Yamaraj is pointing out the problem that it is due to avishuddha buddhaya, that a poor fund of knowledge. They are in ignorance.
Yamaraj 就一个小男孩的样子指出他们的问题，也就是说他们缺乏知识。
Like most of the world today, they're in ignorance about the nature of the material body.
这个世界上绝大多数人对于这个物质躯体的本性都是不了解的。
We were just at the Desharu at the beach resort, and we saw how people come there to enjoy.
我们刚刚去过 Desharu 就是莲花度假村，我们可以看到人们是如何去享受生活的。
And they have so many different varieties of engagements for people to pass their time.
他们有各种各样的活动。 活动可以让人们打发时间。
Right, they have water sports, and they have golf, and they have karaoke.
有水上运动，有高尔夫球，还有 karaoke.
And so many ways, different activities, people will pass their time.
以很多种方式，人们在消磨自己的时光。
Because most people are bored with their life.
因为绝大多数人都对自己的生活感到厌倦。
They say that more people go to psychiatrists because of boredom than any other problem.
据说有越来越多的人去精神病院，是因为他们只是觉得太烦了。
They don't know how to make use of their valuable time in the human body.
他们不知道如何充分利用自己在人类躯体之中的生命。
But for the devotees of the Lord, this is not a problem.
但是对于主的奉献者来说呢，这不是一个问题。
We are never bored.
我们永远不会觉得没意思。
We always have too much to do.
我们总是有太多的事情要做了。
We have so many books to read.
我们有好多的书来读。
We have so many lectures to go to.
我们要听好多的讲课。
We have so many activities for the worship of the deities.
我们有好多的活动要去崇拜神像。
Just looking at the altar and seeing Prabhupada's Vyasasana, how it is decorated so wonderfully. We don't think about the devotees, how they labored for hours to put all of these flowers so artistically in place.
我们只要看一看神坛，再看一看舍勒帕帕德的 Vyasasana, 可能不会想到在这背后有多少奉献者花了很多个小时来进行这种装扮，因为他们非常好的用一种艺术的方式装饰了这些。
So much labor was required to make this wonderful presentation for the pleasure of the deities and Srila Prabhupada and all the devotees.
为了取悦神像，取悦 Srila Prabhupada 还有所有的奉献者，有多少奉献者辛勤劳作了多少个小时？
We don't think about it, we just come and enjoy.
我们不去想这些，只是来了就享受。
And material life is often like that. We just simply want to enjoy. We don't think about all the trouble people go to.
物质的生活也像这样一样，我们只是想着怎么能够享受，不会去想人们要经历多少的艰难。
Nobody's thinking that one day,We will have to leave the body.
没有人想到有一天我要离开这个躯体。
Prahlad Maharaj told to his friends when he was in the Gurukula, he told his friends about the nature of human life.
Prahlad Maharaj 当他还在 Gurukula 的时候，他就给他的朋友们讲这个人体生命的本质。
And then he told them from the beginning of life we should cultivate knowledge of Bhagavad Dharma.
他说在生命的一开始我们就应该培养 Bhagavad Dharma 的知识。
He said we spend the first 20 years of our life playing with balls, playing some kind of ball game.
他说我们把生命的前20年都花在玩球的游戏上了。
And then you spend the last 20 years of your life in poor health, trying to maintain your health.
然后在你生命的最后20年，你是苦苦挣扎的想维系自己的健康状况，你会身体非常糟糕。
And then the middle part of our life is all spent working all day.
而我们生命的中间的部分都花在整天工作了。
Working from early in the morning till late at night.
从一大早就开始工作，一直到晚上很晚。
Just trying to maintain our life in this material world.
只是为了维系我们在这个物质世界里的生活。
And then you have to sleep, you have to spend some time sleeping.
而且还要睡觉，睡觉也是要花时间的。
You spend some time to get food, to cook food or eat food.
还需要花时间去得到食物，然后再烹煮食物，再去吃这个食物。
And in this way, practically, there's no time left.
这样的话，几乎不剩什么时间了。
It's a problem for people that they spend their whole life just working like that and no time to ever think about the goal of life.
这就是一个问题，人们把时间全都花在这些事情上，而对于追求生命的目标就没有时间了。
So Srila Prabhupada quotes this famous verse from the Mahabharata, which is spoken by Maharaj Yudhisthira.
于是施乐帕帕德引用了来自于 Mahabharata 的这个著名诗节，这个诗节是 Maharaj Yudhisthira 所讲述的。
The Pandavas had gone to get water from a lake, but that lake was guarded by a yaksha, and the yaksha would challenge everyone to answer his questions.
Pandava 五兄弟他们去一个湖边取水，但是在这个湖边呢住着一个 yaksha， 这个 yaksha 挑战每一个人问他们问题。
And the different Pandavas, Bhima, Arjuna, Nakula, Sadi, they'd all gone, and none of them were able to.Answer or satisfy the yaksha, and they were all taken by the yaksha. They were all put into coma.
Panda 五兄弟之中的其他的人 ，Bhima、Arjuna、Nakula、Sahadev， 他们全都去，但是都没有能够回答得了，没有能满足得了这个 yaksha， 于是被这个 yaksha 带走，所有人处在昏迷之中。
But Maharaj Yudhisthira came, and Maharaj Yudhisthira, he was asked, what is the most wonderful thing in the world?
Maharaj Yudhisthira 来了，然后他就问 Maharaj Yudhisthira, 在这个世界上最奇妙的事情是什么？
And Maharaj Yudhisthira replied that the most wonderful thing is that everyone is going to die, but nobody's thinking, nobody's preparing themselves for that.
Maharaj Yudhisthira 说最令人惊奇的事情就是在这个世界上每一个人都要死，可是没有人想到这一点，也没有人为此做出任何的准备。
They say there is one temple everyone is going to go to.
据说有一座庙，每一个人都会去到这座庙。
That is the temple of Yamaraj.
那就是 Yamaraj 的庙。
We're going to go there at the end of life.
我们在生命的末尾就会去那个庙。
But people are all thinking, no, no, we'll live forever, we'll live a long time.
但人们都想着，不不，我会活得永远活下去，我会活得很久。
And even you get people who think that I won't die, even if I die, we'll find some medicine to bring me back to life again.
他们甚至想着，即使我死了，以后的人也会发明一种药，让我再活过来。
Many years ago, there was a famous man, Walt Disney.
很多年之前有一个著名人物，他的名字叫沃尔特·迪斯尼。
He was the creator of the many characters famous in the world today, like Donald Duck and Mickey Mouse.
他特别著名是因为他创作了很多的受人欢迎的角色，比如说有唐老鸭，还有米老鼠。
And they have aDisneyland.
他们还创办了迪士尼乐园。
So he got some sickness, and he knew he was going to die. But he made a will, and in his will, he had it written that his body should be put into a refrigerator and frozen. And then he said, when they find the cure for my disease, then bring me out and bring me back to life.
他生了病，知道自己马上要不久于人世，所以他就立了一个特殊的遗嘱。他说：“你们要把我的躯体放在冰箱里冷冻起来，然后等到人们终于找到了治疗我这个疾病的方法，再让我复活过来。”
So he's still in the refrigerator.
他还被冻在那个冰箱里呢。
Because he never found the cure from death.
因为别人还没有找到治疗死亡的方法。
So we have to understand that death is certain.
我们必须要明白到死亡一定会发生。
Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says, Jatashihi dhruvamritju dhruvam janma mritashyacha. For one who has taken birth, death is certain.
在 Bhagavad Gita 之中谈到，对一个已经出生的人来讲呢，死亡是一定会发生的。
And for one who is dead, he won't take birth again.
而对于一个死亡的人，他一定会再次出生。
So, a thoughtful person will consider where do you want to go in the future.
因此，一个思虑周全的人会考虑一下未来他会去哪里。
People are always talking about the future, They're thinking only in the terms of the body, the future of this body.
人们总是在考虑未来，但是他们考虑的是这个躯体的未来。
They go and study, they want to get education, get qualification, because it will help them for a better future. They talk about the future.
他们去上学，接受非常好的教育，这是为了以后找到好工作，他们觉得这个就是未来，这就是他们所想要的美好的未来。
But they're only thinking about the future in a very short-term way, in terms of this body.
但是他们所考虑的未来呢，是一个短期的未来，只是跟这个躯体有关的未来。
Nobody is thinking about the future body, what body you're going to take in the next life.
没有人会去考虑你的未来的躯体的这种未来，未来你会接受一个什么样的躯体。
So we have to understand very clearly what is our goal, where do we want to go?
我们要非常清晰地去想一想。我们的目标是什么？我们要去往何方？
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Yam Yam Papi Smaram Babam Chachiti Anti Kalevaram. Whatever you remember at the end of life, that will determine your destination in the next life.
Krishna 在 Bhagavad Gita 之中说，你在死亡的时候想到什么样的状况，那你在下一世肯定会达到那种境况。
You think of your dog, next life you can become a dog.
如果你想着你的狗，下一世你会成为一条狗。
But if we think of Krishna, then we can go to be with Krishna.
但如果你想着 Krishna, 那么我们就可以跟 Krishna 在一起。
Antakale chamami vasmaranubha kalevaram. Lord Krishna said, one who remembers me, at the end, he will come to me without fail.
主 Krishna 说，如果一个人在临死的时候想着我，他一定会来到我身边。
So we spend our time in Krishna consciousness practicing remembering Krishna.
我们在努力地修习 Krishna 知觉，就是在练习意念 Krishna.
We want to hear about Krishna. We want to serve Krishna. We want to see Krishna.
我们想去聆听跟 Krishna 有关的一切，我们想去服务 Krishna.我们想去做跟 Krishna 所有有关的这些方面。
We come to the temple, Krishna can see us.
我们来到庙宇， Krishna 能够见到我们。
We want to get that opportunity to come closer to Krishna.
我们想得到这种机会，能够更接近 Krishna.
So the human life is a gift given to us by the grace of God.
因此人体的生命是一个礼物，是神的恩慈所致。
It's an opportunity to prepare ourselves for getting out of this world.
这是一个机会，让我们为离开这个世界做出准备。
If we are careful to use this human life, then this can be the last life in the material world.
如果我们小心翼翼地去利用好这个躯体的话，这将是我们在这个物质世界里的最后一世。
We have the book, maybe you've read that book, Coming Back.
我们有一本书，可能你们大家已经读过了，叫《再回来》。
And the last chapter of the book is called Don't Come Back.
而这本书的最后一章叫做《不要再回来》。
Because if we come back, it means we have failed in our previous life.
因为如果我们再回来的话，这就意味着我们的前一世失败了。
Just like...If you're studying at college and you take some exam and you fail the exam, then you have to repeat the course again. It's a lot of trouble.
就像在上大学的时候，你上课，结果最后你没考及格，那么你就必须要把这个课重新上一遍，是一件很麻烦的事情。
And we don't want that kind of trouble. We certainly can do without it.
我们不想要经历那样的麻烦，我们可以避免。
So Yamaraj is warning the queens that don't take this risk. Be careful about your own life.
Yamaraj 在警告这些王后们，你们要小心，你们好好过好自己的生活。
Your husband is gone. He's left you. Now it's up to you. Take care of yourself. Your husband's not going to be looking after you anymore.
你们的丈夫已经走了，不会再回来了。现在你们的职责是好好照顾自己。
So the same way we have the human body, It's a special gift. It's rare to get the human form of life.
同样道理，我们有这个人类的躯体，这是很罕见的，很难得到这种人类的躯体。
And it's even more rare to get association with the devotees.
而得到奉献者们的联谊，那就更罕见了。
There are so many living entities. Only a few have the human body.
有很多的生物体，但是只有少数的生物体能得到人类的躯体。
Right, 400,000 species of human species, but 84 light species of living entities.
人类呢就有400,000种，而在所有的生物体，这个把它加在一起，一共840,000种。
So human beings are rare on the planet.
所以人类在这个星球上是很罕见的。
And devotees are even more rare.
而奉献者们甚至更加的罕见。
Just like sometimes devotees have been trying to find devotees, they've been looking for devotees, trying to find association.
就像有的时候奉献者在很努力地要寻找其他的奉献者，他们想要得到奉献者的联谊。
Very rare, very difficult sometimes to find out where are the devotees.
非常的罕见，有的时候你发现要找到其他的奉献者是很困难的一件事情。
Just like one time some of our devotees, they came to Malaysia and they were looking for the Krishna temple.
就像有一次我们有奉献者来到马来西亚，他们在寻找 Krishna 的庙宇。
And this happened several years ago, before the COVID.
这个是在几年之前，在这个疫情之前。
So they came to Malaysia, they had some relatives in Kuala Lumpur, and they were looking, where is Krishna temple?
他在马来西亚到了吉隆坡，有一些亲戚，然后就帮着打听那 Krishna 的庙在哪里。
And they were taken to different places. They couldn't find the Krishna temple.
就带着他们去各种不同的地方，找不到 Krishna 的庙宇。
I told them you should have said Hare Krishna temple.
然后我告诉他们说，你应该找到一个 Hare Krishna 的庙。
If you just say Krishna temple, they'll take you to some South Indian.Temple, nothing to do with Krishna consciousness.
因为如果你只是说是 Krishna 的庙，可能人家就会带你去一个南印度的一个地方，跟 Krishna 知觉没有任何的关系。
But when we say Hare Krishna, then the people, you may be lucky. You may find somebody who knows where is Hare Krishna.
但如果你说 Hare Krishna, 那可能你会比较幸运。可能有人就会带着你去找到一个咱们的这种庙。
But we see Kuala Lumpur is a big city. There's so many people. There are so few devotees.
我们可以看到吉隆坡是一个很大的城市，有这么多的人，但是奉献者的数量却很少。
You get lost and you ask them, "Do you know where is Hare Krishna? Where is Krishna?" They want to know.
如果你迷路了，你问别人 Hare Krishna 在哪里？然后他们都不知道。
And the same way in material world, so many people are lost. They don't know where to go.
同样道理，在物质世界里，有很多的人其实都是迷失了的，他们不知道应该去往何方。
They have no purpose in life.
他们的生命之中没有目标。
People go clubs, they go to bars, they go to drugs, they go to sports.
人们去俱乐部，他们去酒吧。然后呢，去服用一些麻醉品，甚至呢，去做一些其他的这些活动。
According to their association with the modes of nature, some will be inclined more to the mode of goodness, some to the mode of passion, and others to the mode of ignorance.
就是按照他们跟物质自然属性相关系的程度，有的人可能他们的活动处在善良属性之中，有的人呢就在激情属性之中，有的人是在愚昧属性之中。
It takes some good fortune to contact the devotees.
一定要有非常大的幸运才能够接触到奉献者。
To meet a devotee and find out about a higher purpose in life.
找到一位奉献者，去寻觅生命之中更高的目标。
Because doesn't matter what you do in the material world, it will not help you.For preparing for death.
因为在物质世界里，无论你做什么，都不能够帮助你为死亡做出准备。
Oh, you may go running, you may go jogging every day. You say it will keep you healthy.
每天可能你去跑步，或者你去 慢跑，你觉得这个可能让你保持健康。
Some people like to go swimming and keep healthy that way.
有的人喜欢去游泳，用这种方式来保持身体健康。
But it will not protect you from death.
但这个不能保护你免于死亡。
How much you can swim, how much you can run, it's not going to save you from the miseries of the material world.
你能游多少泳，你能跑多少步，这个都不能够保证让你脱离这个物质世界。
We're thinking we can conquer the material nature, but nobody is successful.
我们想着我们可以征服物质自然，但是到目前为止还没有人成功。
And Prabhupada talks about the scientists, they're making plans, they're promising people a longer life.
Prabhupada 就谈到那些科学家们在制定计划，他们答应要让人们更加的长寿。
They're saying people will live up to 120 and 150, they'll be 150 years old.
他们说人们能够达到120岁，能够活到150岁。
That's not going to solve the problem of life.
但仍然他们无法解决生命的基本问题。
We still have to give up the material body one day.
终于有一天，我们还是要放弃这个物质躯体。
And usually when people get older, they're happy to give up the material body.
通常当人们年迈的时候，他们会很高兴放弃自己的躯体。
Of course, when we leave the body, the relatives may lament, they may cry, oh, he's gone.
当然，当我们离开躯体的时候呢，我们的亲戚们可能会非常的难过，他们会哭，哦，他走了。
But the person who's gone, he's happy, he's glad to get out of the body.
但是那个走了的人，他很高兴。他特别高兴能够终于离开这个躯体。
Because living in the material body is just so much suffering.
因为住在物质躯体之中，仅仅意味着很多的痛苦。
So many difficulties.
有很多的困难。
Jagadaka Maharaj was talking about all the problems he has with this material body.
Jagadaka Maharaj 谈到他的这个物质躯体所面临的所有的问题。
He has to go for an operation on his eye. He's got a cataract in the eye.
他要去进行一次眼科手术，因为他长了白内障。
And he's got to go for regularly for the dialysis.
而且他还要经常的去进行肾透析。
So many troubles. His kidney is not functioning so well.
很多的麻烦，他的肾脏不好好工作了。
But he tolerates all of these things because he has so much duties to do in this world. He has so many people depending on him.
他忍受所有的这一切的困难，是因为他在这个世界上有很多的职责要履行，有很多的人都要依靠他。
So for the service of Krishna, Maharaj tolerates. He decides to stay in this world.
为了服务 Krishna, Maharaj 忍受所有的一切，他决定待在这个物质世界里。
But ultimately, we're all under the control of Lord Krishna.
但是最终极的来讲，我们所有的人都受到 Krishna 的控制。
We say, Mare Krishna Rake Ke, Rake Krishna Mare. If Krishna wants someone to live, nobody can kill him.
我们说 Mare Krishna Rake Ke Rake Krishna Mare Ke 如果 Krishna 想杀一个人，没有人能救得了他。
So devotee is dependent on Krishna, he surrendered to Krishna.
所以一个奉献者，他依靠 Krishna, 他臣服于 Krishna.
We live by the grace of Krishna and we die by the grace of Krishna.
我们活着要靠 Krishna 的恩慈，我们死亡也要靠 Krishna 的恩慈。
Jiva Goswami,In one commentation on the Purport in Srimad Bhagavatam, he describes about four different men who came to the astrologer.
Jiva Goswami 在评论 Srimad Bhagavatam 一个师节的时候，谈到有四种人来到一个占星师的面前。
And he tells first of all about how the king's son came, and he blessed the king's son.Jiva, he blessed the king's son, Rajaputra Charanjiva. Right, we have Charanjiva here, Charanjeeva Das. But there's another, Charanjeeva means you live forever, you don't die.
那么首先来到占星师面前的是一个王子，他就祝福这个王子 Rajaputra Charanjeeva， 我们这里有 Charanjeeva Prabhu， 意思就是说一直活着不死。
但是 Charanjeeva Das，
他是 Charanjeeva Das，
Descendant，
right? 是仆人。
But the astrologer blessed the king's son.May you live forever. Don't die.
这个占星师就祝福国王的儿子，愿你永远活着，不要死。
Because he's a king's son, he's a rascal. Number one, does all kinds of nonsense. He enjoys his father's money.
因为他是国王的儿子，所以他是头号的混蛋。他在用他的父亲的钱，在拼命的享受。
And he's doing a lot of sinful activities.
而且他做了很多的罪恶活动。
So the astrologer said, "Live forever. Better you don't die."
于是占星师说，最好你还是一直活着，不要死。
Because when he dies, next life will not be very good.
因为如果他死了，下一世肯定是非常不好的。
And then the rishi came with his son.And the rishi and his son, they live in the forest, and they just eat whatever grows in the forest.
接着，一位 rishi 带着自己的儿子来了，他们住在森林里，他们吃的都是森林里长的东西。
You know, you live in the forest, it's a great austerity.
你们知道吗？住在森林里是一种极大的苦行。
And so the rishi brought his son, and the astrologer said, Rajaputra Majiva Rishiputraka. The Rishiputraka means the son of the Rishi. Majiva. He said, don't live. In other words, may your death come soon.
当他们来到占星师的面前的时候呢，这个占星师就说，Rishiputra Majiva Rishiputra Majiva 的意思就是你可以马上死，然后 Rishiputra 就指的是你是这个圣人的儿子。
Because he's doing so much tapasya, he's not doing any sinful thing, no harm to anyone.
因为他一直在做 tapasya, 他一直在苦行，他没有任何罪恶活动，没有伤害任何人。
So next life, he'll get very good birth.
因此下一世他可以得到很好的出生。
So the astrologer blessed him, may your death come soon.
于是占星师祝福他，愿你的死亡尽快到来。
And then,The butcher came.
然后来了一个屠夫。
And he said, butcher or hunter, they're called Vyadi. Vyadi, Majiva, Mamara. Don't live, don't die.
然后这个屠夫或者是猎人被称为是 Vyadi. 然后这个占星师就说呢，那既不要 Majiva,
Mamara.
既不要活着也不要死。
Because you're living in hell,Every day, cutting the meat, killing the animals, you're living in hell, next life you will go to hell.
因为当你活着的时候，你每天杀动物、切肉，然后就是住在地狱里。如果死了的话呢，也是要下地狱。
So, the astrologer told the man, you know, better you don't live and don't die also.
所以占星师跟他说呢，最好你不要活着，也不要死。
But then the devotee came with his son.
然后一个奉献者带着他的儿子来了。
Sadhu, Rajaputra, Charanjeeva, Majiva, Rishiputra, Jivava, Marava, Sadhu. Sadhu, the sadhu, the devotee, they're all sadhus.Jivava Marava Sadhu. He said, for the devotee, it doesn't matter if you live or if you die.
Jivava Marava Sadhu. 意思就是说，对一个圣人来讲，既可以活着，也可以死。
Because the devotee, every day, chanting the holy name, he's taking nice prasadam, he's seeing the deities, he's in a very good environment.
因为一个奉献者，他每天荣耀菩萨的，他唱诵圣名，他见神像，他的这个生活的氛围是非常美好的。
And if he dies, next life he will go on and serve Krishna some other place.
如果他死了的话，下一世他会继续在另外的一个地方去服务 Krishna。
But it doesn't make any difference for a devotee if he lives or if he dies.
对一个奉献者而言，他活着还是死了没有什么区别。
Because it's going to be simply service to Krishna.
因为仅仅都意味着对 Krishna 的服务。
Even you go to hell, hell will become heaven with Krishna consciousness.
即使他下了地狱，但是因为有 Krishna 知觉，连地狱都会变成天堂。
But if you go to heaven without Krishna, it will become hell.
但如果你要是去了天堂，却没有 Krishna 知觉，那就会在地狱一样。
So we have to understand how fortunate the devotee is.
我们要明白到奉献者是多么的幸运。
That in whatever condition we're in, it's not a problem for a devotee.
无论我们身处任何的境况，对一个奉献者而言都不是问题。
Narayana parasave nakutasjanyavidyate swarga apavarga narakesh vapitu yatadarshana.For the one who has taken shelter of Lord Narayan, who surrendered himself to the Lord, then there's no difference between Narak, meaning hell, or Swarga, heaven, or Apavarga, liberation.
据说 Narayan Parasarve, Nakutaschana Pipeti, Swarga Pavarga, Narakeshva Pituli Yarta Darshanaha,如果一个奉献者他努力地服务主拿拉耶呢，也就是他一直专注在对主的奉献服务之中，对于他来讲，无论是去天堂还是下地狱还是解脱都没有任何的区别，因为 Naraka 的意思就是下地狱， Svarga 的意思就是上天堂， Apavarga 的意思就是解脱。
When devotee sees all these places equally,
一个奉献者平等地看待所有这些地方，
Wherever he goes, he's going to do the same thing.
无论他去什么地方，他都会做同样的事情。
He's going to chant Hare Krishna. He's going to read the books, read Srimad Bhagavatam.
他要唱诵 Hare Krishna. 他要读书，他要阅读 Srimad Bhagavatam.
He's going to worship Krishna.
他会崇拜 Krishna.
So the devotee doesn't see any difference between one place and another.
所以奉献者不会看到一个地方跟另外的一个地方有任何的区别。
Material people in the bodily concept of life have a very different understanding.
可是处在物质躯体化生命概念之中的人，他们却有相当不一样的理解。
When they're trying to plan for happiness, they're trying to make arrangements for their comfort.
他们试图做出一些计划。他们试图为了 未来的这种舒适的生活做出安排。
But devotees of Krishna are not on the bodily platform.
但是 Krishna 的奉献者并不处在躯体的这种层面上。
And they can accept any difficulties by the grace of Krishna.
他们可以通过 Krishna 的恩慈接受任何的艰难。
And go on chanting the holy name and worshiping Krishna.
并且继续唱诵主的圣名，而且要崇拜 Krishna。
It is not a problem for the devotee.
对于奉献者而言，没有任何的问题。
We see the example Kalavika Sridhar.
我们可以看到一个很好的例子是 Kalavika Sridhar.
How he was living in a very dilapidated structure for his home. It was very broken down and there were holes in the roof.But he was living there happily, chanting the holy name.
我们可以看到他如何生活在一座破败不堪的小茅屋里，房子都快烂掉了，而且这个屋顶上还有洞，但他非常快乐地住在他的这个地方，每天唱诵。
And he only had an old iron lota, which he used to drink water from.
他只有一个铁做的 lota, 一个铁罐子用来喝水。
And he used that lota also to wash his feet.
他还用这个 lota 去洗他的脚。
So one time, one day Lord Chaitanya came there and he got that lota and he drank the water from it.
有一天主宰看见到了他的家，拿起他的这个 lota 就开始喝水。
Sridhar felt very sorry. He did not like to see Lord Chaitanya do that.
Sridhar 感觉非常的难过，他不愿意看到主宰看见这样做。
And when Lord Chaitanya wanted to give blessings to Sridhar, Sridhar said, no, I'm happy, I just want to go on as I'm doing.
主 Chaitanya 想给 Sridhar 一个祝福，但是 Sridhar 说，我什么都不需要，我现在这个样子就很好了。
Whatever income I get, 50% goes for the worship of Mother Ganga.
他无论有多少收入，50%都用来崇拜恒河母亲。
And he had a very small income.
他的收入非常的微薄。
But still, he liked to do this worship of Mother Ganga, and he was worshiping Mother Ganga not for material benefit, but as a devotee.
但他仍然愿意用这种微薄的收入的一半来崇拜恒河母亲，而且他的崇拜不是为了得到任何物质的好处，而完全是为了取悦恒河母亲。
So we want to understand the nature of devotional service, and we want to be appreciative of our good fortune.
因此，我们想好好的利用我们奉献服务的机会，这样我们就可以充分的得到我们的幸运。
Okay, any questions?
好吧，请问有什么问题吗？
Oh, today, of course, is the auspicious day of the appearance day of Srimati Radharani.
当然了，今天是非常吉祥的 Srimati Radharani 的显现日。
Srimati Radharani, of course, appears in Varsana as the daughter of Maharaj Vrishabhanu in Kirtila.
当然了 ，Srimati Radharani 显现在 Varsana， 她是 Maharaj Vrishabhanu 和 Kirtita 母亲的女儿。
There will be a very big crowd there in Varsana today, I'm sure.
今天我确信在 Varsana 会有特别多的人。
So Srimati Radharani is the pleasure potency of Lord Krishna.
Srimati Radharani 是主 Krishna 的喜乐能量。
It is said Radha and Krishna are one.But they separated themselves eternally in the forms of Radha and Krishna.
据说 Radha and Krishna 本来是一，但是他们永恒的分开，就成为了 Radha Krishna 的形体。
而 Srimati Radharani only has the thought of service to Krishna.
Srimati Radharani 唯一的想法就是去服务 Krishna.
And everything which she does is for giving pleasure to Krishna.
她所做的一切都是为了去取悦 Krishna.
She is an ocean of good qualities, but there are two special qualities which are very dear to Lord Krishna.
她是一个好品质的海洋，但在所有这些好品质之中，有两项最突出的，特别取悦主 Krishna.
One is that she is very expert in cooking, and she will cook for Lord Krishna.
其中之一，她非常擅长烹调，她每天都为 Krishna 去烹调。
She had been blessed by Durvasa Muni that everything she would cook would taste like nectar.
她受到了 Durvasa Muni 的祝福，无论她做什么，吃起来都像甘露一样。
So Mother Yashoda invited Srimati Radharani to come and cook for Krishna because Krishna would go to the forest during the daytime and come home at night, he'd be quite hungry after being in the forest all day and only eating some rice and yogurt. So when he came home, he was ready to have a good supper.
Yashoda 妈妈就邀请 Srimati Radharani 来帮助她给 Krishna 做饭，是因为 Krishna 白天的时候要去森林里放牛，然后晚上回家来吃晚饭。而在森林里放牛的时候，只能吃一些酸奶和米饭。因此在晚上回家的时候 Krishna 会非常的饥饿，他会期待着要好好的吃一顿晚餐。
So Mother Yashoda knew Radharani had this blessing, so she invited Radharani to come there to their home and cook for Lord Krishna. And Radharani would cook the whole day. She'd cook and begin cooking in the morning and cook right through until Krishna came home in the evening.
亚修的妈妈知道 Radharani 得到了这个祝福，所以她就邀请 Radharani 每天来为 Krishna 做饭。而 Radharani 她从早上就开始做饭了，她一天都在做饭，一直做到 Krishna 回家。
She's cooking in the fire of separation from Lord Krishna.
她是在用跟 Krishna 的分离之火在做这个饭。
And Lord Krishna will sometimes tease Radharani.
有的时候主 Krishna 会取笑 Radharani.
He enjoys sometimes seeing how his devotees will respond.
Krishna 很喜欢看到他奉献者会对此有什么样的反应。
So one day, Srimati Radharani had spent many hours preparing a very special sweet for Lord Krishna.
有一天 ，Radharani 花了好几个小时为 Krishna 准备了一道特殊的甜品。
And when it was offered to Krishna, Radharani was anxious to see how much Krishna would enjoy the sweet, and she stood.Behind the door, looking at Krishna, watching to see how he would respond.
当做好了之后要给 Krishna 吃 ，Radharani 就想看看 Krishna 吃完了是什么样的反应。于是他就悄悄地藏在了门后面。
So Krishna could understand Radharani was watching him.
Krishna 知道 Radharani 在偷看他。
So he saw this sweet, and he understood that Radharani must have been working many hours to prepare this sweet.
他看着这个甜品就知道 Radharani 一定是努力了好几个钟头来准备这道甜品。
So he took a tiny crumb from the sweet and he put it on his tongue and then he screwed up, his face, indicating that it was not very pleasant.
Krishna 就从这个甜品上抓了一小丢丢点放在自己的舌头上，然后做出皱眉头撅嘴的这么姿势。就看起来好像这个特别难吃的样子。
And Radharani is watching it. And maybe I did something wrong.
Radharani 看到这个情景，然后就觉得，可能我做错了什么吧。
But then Krishna took the sweet and he gave it to Madhu Mangal, his fat Brahmin friend.
接着 Krishna 就把这个甜品给了他身边的胖 Brahmin 的朋友 Madhu Mangal。
And Madhu Mangal takes a little crumb of the sweet, he puts it on his tongue and goes, wow.
Madhu Mangal 取了一点点放在自己的舌头上，然后露出一副非常令人惊讶的表情。哇
！So much nectar.
真的是太甘露的味道了。
This is all the loving dealings between Lord Krishna and Srimati Radharani.
这就是在主 Krishna 还有 Srimati Radharani 之间的交往。
Giving pleasure to Krishna.
为 Krishna 带来喜乐。
And Radharani's other quality, which Krishna also takes great pleasure in, is her dancing.
还有 Radharani 有一个品质是 Krishna 非常喜欢的，那就是她的舞蹈。
Lord Krishna likes to dance.
主 Krishna 喜欢跳舞。
We know he danced Rasa Lila with all the gopis.
我们知道他跟所有的 gopi 们跳 Rasa 之舞。
And sometimes he likes to also dance, but just.Radharani.
但有的时候他也想只跟 Radharani 去跳舞。
They enjoy, sometimes they will dance just as a peacock stands.
他们有的时候这种跳舞的享受呢，就像是孔雀们在跳舞一样。
There's a temple, more temple there in Varsana.
在 Varsana 有一个庙叫做 More 庙，孔雀庙。
And it's a place where Radha and Krishna appeared like peacocks dancing, and it's like peacocks.
这个地方呢 ，Radha and Krishna 他们就变得像孔雀一样，在跳这个孔雀舞。
And so Radharani, she's Srimati Radharani, she is the queen of Vrindavan because she can give the greatest pleasure to Lord Krishna.
Srimati Radharani 是 Vrindavan 的王后，因为她能给主 Krishna 带来最大的快乐。
And the pleasure she gets is even greater than the pleasure Krishna gets.
而他所得到的快乐甚至要超过 Krishna 得到的快乐。
And so, Chaitanya Charitamrita, it is described how Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, how Lord Krishna came as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu just to experience the pleasure which is being taken by Srimati Radharani.
在《Chaitanya Charitamrita》之中描述到 ，Krishna 成为主 Chaitanya 降临，就是为了能够体验到 Srimati Radharani 所体验到的快乐。
Right, Chaitanya Charitamrita describes the external reason for Lord Chaitanya coming to establish the Sankirtan movement and the chanting of the holy name.
《Chaitanya Charitamrita》之中描述到，主 Krishna 作为主 Chaitanya 显现的外在原因，那就是确立。Sankirtan 的运动让所有的人去唱诵圣名。
But there was a confidential reason for the appearance of Mahaprabhu.
但是 Mahaprabhu 的显现也有一个机密的原因。
And that was to understand and experience and taste the nectar which is there in the mood of Srimati Radharani.
那就是去品味 Srimati Radharani 她的情感所能够品味到的甘露还有那种喜乐。
And so Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to understand the opulences of Lord Krishna.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 想能够去理解主 Krishna 的富裕
The wonderful qualities which he has
也就是他所拥有的奇妙的品质
Which are so much appreciated by Radharani
这是 Radharani 所充分欣赏的
And he wants to also understand the pleasure which she feels when she understands how much Krishna likes her
他也想理解，就是说 ，Krishna 作为主产，他呢也想去理解 Radharani。当他爱 Krishna 的时候，他所感受 Radharani 所感受到的那种快乐。
Just like in the material world, a young man and a young woman, they may have attraction for each other.
就像是在物质世界里，一个年轻的男子和一个年轻的女子，他们彼此之间受到吸引。
So the young woman enjoys She's attracted to the young man.
年轻的女子受到年轻男子的吸引。
But when she sees that the young man is attracted to her, then she feels even more pleasure.
但是当她看到年轻的男子也受到自己的吸引的时候，她甚至可以感受到更多的喜悦。
So Srimati Radharani was appreciating this in the loving exchange with Lord Krishna.
因此 ，Srimati Radharani。他就在体验，在欣赏这种跟主 Krishna 之间的交往。
And in this way, she's experiencing unlimited pleasure.
这样，他就体验到无限的快乐。
So this is the mood of Srimati Radharani.
这就是 Srimati Radharani 的情感。
We also know from Shikshastikam more about the mood of Srimati Radharani.
我们从 Shikshastakam 八训规之中也可以更多的去了解 Srimati Radharani 的情感。
The final verse of the Shikshastakam prayers are they represent the mood of Srimati Radharani.
在 Shikshastakam 之中的第八个时节就是 Srimati Radharani 的情感的展示。
I know no one but Krishna is my Lord, and he will always remain so.Even though he may handle me roughly by his embrace, or make me broken-hearted by not being present before me, he is completely free to do anything and everything with me, but he is always my worshipful Lord, unconditionally.
除了 Krishna, 谁也不是我的主，即使他拥抱我时对我粗暴，离开我时叫我心碎。他仍然永远是我无条件崇拜的主。
So this is Krishna consciousness on the highest level.
这就是在最高层面上的 Krishna 知觉。
Srimati Radharani is on the highest level of Krishna consciousness.
Srimati Radharani 她处在 Krishna 知觉的最高级的层面。
And she describes how the.She's saying to Krishna that if my being unhappy makes you happy, that is my happiness.
而且她甚至表达这样的一个意思：如果我的不快乐是你的快乐，那么我的不快乐就是我的快乐。
Right? I'm sure all you ladies would say like that to your husbands.
我确保你们这些女生们都是跟自己的老公这样说的吧。
My dear husband.If my being unhappy makes you happy, that's my happiness.
如果我的不快乐能成为你的快乐，那我的不快乐就是我的快乐。
Right?
对吗
？Usually, what happens? A woman will say, "You should make me happy."
通常女人们怎么说？你应该让我快乐。
But Srimati Radharani says to Krishna.If my being unhappy makes you happy, that is my happiness.
但是 Srimati Radharani 对 Krishna 说，如果我的不快乐能让你快乐，那这种不快乐就是我的快乐。
That is prema bhakti on the topmost platform.
那就是 prema bhakti 处在最顶级的层面上。
And Srimati Radharani is also quoted. There's a famous verse which comes in the Chaitanya Charitamrita.
而且 Srimati Radharani 还有一次被引用在 Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita 之中，有一个非常著名的诗节。
There's a verse which is spoken, the words of Srimati Radharani, which are only understood by three people.
其中有一个诗节，就是 Srimati Radharani 亲口讲述的，只有三个人能理解这个诗节的含义。
Three people are Madhavendra Puri, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and Srimati Radharani.
这三个人便是 Madhavendra Puri, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, 还有 Srimati Radharani.
It is said this verse is.Just like there's a special stone called Kastuba Mani, which is a very special precious jewel called Kastuba Mani. So this verse is like the jewel of all poetry of transcendental melodies.
就像是在宝石之中有一种特殊的宝石，被称为是 Kastuba Mani， 这是很价值连城的一种宝石。而这个诗节呢，就好比是在所有表达超然风味情感的诗节之中的珍宝。
And it's also said that just like if you have some sandalwood and you rub the sandalwood, as you rub the sandalwood, the aroma increases, the fragrant aroma of the sandalwood comes more and more the more you rub it.
据说就像檀香木一样，如果你使劲地磨这个檀香木，它的香味就会越来越多地散发出来。
So the same way, the more you consider this verse, the more you contemplate this verse, the more you will enter into the deepest level of Krishna consciousness.
同样道理，如果你越去思考这个诗节，你越去品味这个诗节，越深入地去冥想这个诗节，你就会越来越深入地进入到 Krishna 知觉的更高的层面。
So Srimati Radharani is quoted in the Chaitanya Charitamrita as saying, O my Lord, O my most merciful master of Mathura.
那么在 Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita 之中引用了 Srimati Radharani 的这个诗节，谈到哦，我的主啊，我的Mathura之主啊。
Yeah, Lord Krishna had left Vrindavan and gone to Mathura and become the prince of Mathura.
是的，主 Krishna 离开了 Vrindavan， 他成为了 Mathura 的王子。
Srimati Radharani was left in Vrindavan.
而 Srimati Radharani 却被留在了 Vrindavan.
And she's feeling the separation from Lord Krishna.
他感觉到跟主 Krishna 之间的分离之情。
And so she says to Lord Krishna, O my Lord, O Master of Mathura, when shall I see you again?
于是在悲伤之中，他就感叹道，我的主啊，马图拉之主啊，我何时才能再次见到你？
Because of my not seeing you, my most agitated heart has become unsteady.
因为看不到你，所以我的心意开始变得不安不稳。
So what should I do now?
我现在怎么办呢？
So this verse was recited by Madhavendra Puri, and then it was tasted by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
这个诗节是由 Madhavendra Puri 讲述出来。由主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 所品味的。
And when Mahaprabhu, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu recited it, he became overwhelmed in ecstasy, and he rolled on the ground, and he ran around like a madman.
当主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 在朗诵这个诗节的时候，他就非常的激动，然后满地打滚，像疯子一样到处跑。
He was so ecstatic, he would try to recite the verse. He could not recite the whole verse. He would just say, Ayedina. He would just say the first two words. So, this verse.could only be understood by these three people.
这个师姐只能有这三个人才理解。
Lord Chaitanya took initiation in the line of Madhva Acharya.
主柴坦内是在 Madhva Acharya 的传承之中接受的启迪。
And he took initiation in that line because of Madhavendra Puri.
他之所以要在这个传承之中接受启迪，就是因为 Madhavendra Puri 的缘故。
Because before Madhavendra Puri, there was no.Conjugal love. There was no understanding of the mellow of conjugal love.
因为在 Madhavendra Puri 之前，大家没有对情侣之爱的理解，也就是说，对这种情侣风味的关系是不明白的。
There was worship of Krishna, but there was no conjugal love.
有对 Krishna 的崇拜，但却是没有情侣之爱。
But it was Madhavendra Puri who.Understood this mood of conjugal love.
只有 Madhavendra Puri 他理解这种情侣之爱的情感。
And he recited this verse.
他朗诵了这个诗节。
And he recited this verse again and again as he left the body.
当他离开躯体的时候，他一遍又一遍地朗诵了这个诗节。
So this verse, he said, this verse was spoken by Srimati Radharani.
而这个诗节原本是由 Srimati Radharani 本人讲述的。
Because she's in that mood of separation from Krishna.
因为她处在这种跟 Krishna 分离的情感之中。
And that separation from Krishna is greater than the pleasure of meeting Krishna.
而这种跟 Krishna 分离的情感，胜似跟 Krishna 见面的情感。
So, in the line of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's devotees, in the Gaudiya Sampradaya, they all want to cultivate that mood of service and separation.
因此在主柴坦内马哈帕布的传承之中，在高迭桑普达雅的使徒传系里，大家都在努力地培养这种在分离之中去服务的情感。
Because this is the mood of the gopis in service to Krishna.
因为这就是 gopi 们服务 Krishna 的情感。
One time, one devotee, he prepared a coloring book for children.
有一次，有一个奉献者为孩子们出了一本图画书。
And he put a picture of Krishna and a picture of a devotee, and the devotee saying Krishna sitting by the tree.
然后他画了有一幅画是有 Krishna 有奉献者，然后呢，这个 Krishna 就坐在一棵树下。
And Prabhupada said, "What is this? He said, this is not our philosophy."
Prabhupada 说这是什么？这并不是我们的哲学。
He said, "You should say, where is Krishna?"
你应该说 Krishna 在哪里？
The mood of the Goswamis of Vrindavan, the mood of our line is to cultivate the mood of the gopis, which is the mood of Srimati Radharani.
Vrindavan 六个 Swami 的情感，我们的情感，然后大家的情感都应该是像。Gopi 们像 Srimati Radharani 的情感一样。
And then it is all, where is Krishna?
那个情感就是 Krishna 在哪里？
When will he come?
他什么时候会来？
That is the thinking of Srimati Radharani.
那就是 Srimati Radharani 的思想。
And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was he followed that mood, he cultivated that mood.
而主柴坦的马哈帕布，他追随这种情感，他也在培养这种情感。
So we want to try to understand this concept of service to Lord Krishna, but service in separation.
我们也想培养这种对 Krishna 的服务的情感，但是要培养在分离之中去服务的情感。
We say follow in the footsteps of the gopis.
我们说要追随那些 Gopi 们的步伐。
So what is the mood of the Gopis? The mood is service in separation.
Gopi 们的情感到底是什么？那就是在分离之中的服务。
And the topmost of all the Gopis is Srimati Radharani.
而在所有 Gopi 们之中的佼佼者就是 Srimati Radharani.
And we see her ecstatic love for Krishna appear.When Uddhava came to Vrindavan with a message from Krishna,
我们可以看到他对于主 Krishna 的这种情感的展示。那个时候正好是 Uddhava 带着 Krishna 的讯息去了 Vrindavan.
And she began to talk to a bumblebee and accused the bumblebee of being a messenger from Krishna.
Srimati Radharani 开始跟一只大黄蜂讲话，她是 认为这只大黄蜂就是 Krishna 的信使。
And she said to the bumblebee, "You are the unreliable servant of an unreliable master."
芝麻对 Radharani 说，你是一个靠不住的主人的靠不住的仆人。
That just like the student takes knowledge from the teacher and then they go away, they never come back to thank the teacher.
就像一个学生从老师那儿接受知识，然后他们走了之后再也不回来感谢这个老师了。
Or the bee comes and takes the pollen from the flower and goes away, leaves the flower.
然后也像一只蜜蜂从一朵花上采了这个花粉和蜜，然后离开了这朵花，就飞走了。
In the same way, you're like that. You're ungrateful. You just come to take from me, and you want to go away. You don't have any gratitude.
同样道理，你也是一样。你只想从我这儿拿走一些东西，然后你就离开了，再也不回来了。
Srimati Radharani was expressing her ecstatic love for Krishna by criticizing him.
Srimati Radharani.就在表达他对 Krishna 的狂喜之爱，他表达的方式是通过批评他。
Complaining about him.
抱怨他。
Because he's gone away, gone off to Mathura, he's gone to all the society women in Mathura and left the gopis.
因为他跑了，他去了 Mathura, 他跟那些 Mathura 的社交女郎们待在一起，就是离开了这些 gopi 们。
So Srimati Radharani was talking in this way to the bumblebee.
Srimati Radharani 就以这样的方式跟大黄蜂在讲话。
And when the bumblebee disappeared, then Srimati Radharani became very disturbed that, oh no, where have you gone? Oh, are you going to go to Krishna and tell him what I said?
当这个大黄蜂消失的时候 ，Srimati Radharani 就变得非常的受打扰。哦，怎么了？你去了哪里？你会不会把我刚才说的一切告诉 Krishna？
If you tell Krishna what I said, he will never forgive me.
如果你要是把我刚才说的一切都告诉 Krishna 的话，他永远也不会原谅我了。
And so this way, Radharani became very worried, but then the bumblebee reappeared, and she said, "Oh, again, you've come back. Oh, wonderful. Oh, how nice. So glad to see you."
Radharani 正这样担心的时候，这只大黄蜂又重新显现了。然后 Radharani 说：“哦，你又显现了，太棒了，你简直是太美好了。”
So Uddhava had come from Dwarka with a message from Lord Krishna, and he was witnessing all of this.
Uddhava 他从 Dwarka 来，他带着 Krishna 的信，他目睹了所有的这一切。
Some people say Uddhava was sent there to give knowledge to the gopis.
有的人说 Uddhava 去那个地方是为了给 Gopi 们派发知识。
Because Uddhava is a disciple of Brihaspati, so he is very learned.
因为 Uddhava 是 Brihaspati 的学生，他非常的渊博。
But other devotees know that Uddhava came to learn from the Gopis.
但其他的奉献者知道 Uddhava 到来是为了跟 Gopi 们学习的。
And when Uddhava saw the mood of the gopis and how much love they had for Krishna, then he prayed that he could take birth as a creeper or some grass in Vrindavan.
当 Uddhava 看到这些 gopi 们的情感，看到他们是如何服务 Krishna 的，他就祈祷，他可以变成 Vrindavan 的地上的一个蔓藤。
He knew they would never be.Humble, they will never give me the dust from their feet. They're so humble. How will I ever get the dust from their feet? The only way I can get the dust from their feet is if I can become a blade of grass, and in that way they can walk on me.
他知道，因为那些勾皮们非常的谦卑，永远也不会把他们莲花足下的尘土给我的。那我怎么得到他们莲花足下的尘土呢？那我就只能是变成这个草，就像这个蔓藤一样。
So this example of Srimati Radharani talking to the bumblebee as if he was a messenger from Krishna, this is a display of her Mahabhava, the highest love for Krishna.
所以当 Srimati Radharani 看到大黄蜂的时候，他就把它当成了 Krishna 的一个信使，跟他这样讲话，这是他的 Mahabhava。也就是他对于 Krishna 这种爱的最高级的呈现。
So we are trying to appreciate these wonderful pastimes. on this very special day.
在这特殊的日子里，我们想充分的去欣赏这些非常有荣耀的逍遥时光。
Are there any questions?
有什么问题吗？
迪拜部落队，我的问题是什么呢？就是沟皮和牧牛姑娘有什么不同？也就是沟皮和牧牛姑娘的概念有何区别？有何区别？我的问题完了。
A basis is to Gurudev. My question is, what is the difference between gopi and the cowherd girls?
No.
没有区别。
对，好了，老师。哎，老师，谢谢你，我就想清楚这一点。好，不是的。
Gopis are the cowherd girls, and gopas are the cowherd boys.
Gopi 就指的是牧牛姑娘 ，gopa 指的就是牧牛童。
Gopi and gopa.
Gopi 和 gopa.
Cowherd girls are cowherd.Okay. Any other questions?
还有问题吗
？Yes, Yan.
明白，姑姑。感恩各位奉献者。我的问题是，那个大黄蜂来到Shri Mata Radharani 跟前，然后勾起那个 Radharani 对 Krishna 的思念。来了又走，走了又来，这个场景是不是 Krishna 刻意安排的一个逍遥时光
？A business is to Guru. I'm very grateful to all the devotees. My question is, the bumblebee appeared in front of Radharani and then disappeared again, coming and going. Is that a special arrangement by Krishna for pastime?
It's an arrangement of bumblebees.
这个是
they do like that. They come and go. They fly around.
这个是大黄蜂的安排，它们就飞来飞去的。
Have you never had bumblebees coming flying around?
你周围从来没有大黄蜂飞来飞去的吗
？If you go to Mayapur, there's a lot of bumblebees.
如果你去 Mayapur， 就会发现有很多的大黄蜂。
So it's the nature. They move here and there. They come.
这是他们的本性，他们就是飞来飞去的。
When Srimati Radharani is seeing them as messengers of Krishna.
Srimati Radharani 看到了，就认为这是 Krishna 的信使。
So it's a very high level of love for Krishna.
这是一种对 Krishna 的非常。高级层面的爱。
You have to read the passage more.
你应该更多的去阅读这个逍遥时光。
But when the bumblebee went out of sight, then it increased her love for Krishna. She became more anxious. That oh, what's happened? Where is he gone?
当这个大黄蜂消失的时候。Srimati Radharani 就爱的欢喜的程度也在增加，他很担心哦，他去哪儿了？怎么不见了？
Yes.
Hare Krishna Maharaj， 我的问题是，如果 Krishna， 我们知道 Krishna 他知晓一切，所以为什么Krishna 需要化身为 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 来去？感受 Radharani 对 Krishna 的爱呢，是因为这种体验会更加的强烈吗
？We know Krishna knows everything. Then why? What is the necessity for him to incarnate as Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Is that because in this way he can experience in a more intensive way?
Yes. Well, the way it is described to us by the Acharyas is that Lord Krishna.Considers himself to be the supreme enjoyer.
Acharya 们所给我们的解释是主 Krishna 他被认为是至高无上的享受者。
Yes, he knows everything.
是的，他了解所有的一切。
And he likes to enjoy everything.
而且他想享受所有的一切。
But he thought that the gopis were enjoying more than him.
但是他发现 gopi 们的享受超过他。
That their pleasure is many thousands of times greater than my pleasure.
他们的快乐居然胜过我的快乐好几千倍。
I want to experience that pleasure.
我想去体验那种快乐。
Even we also understand, we say like, it's better to give than to receive. There's more pleasure in giving something than in receiving something.
其实我们平常也会说给比拿要有更多的快乐，我们最好还是给别人，而不是说总是从别人那里去索取。
So the gopis, they're giving everything to Krishna. They're giving their self, their service, they're giving their bodies, their minds, everything is so absorbed in Krishna.
这些 gopi 们牧牛姑娘们把她们所有的一切都给了 Krishna, 把服务给 Krishna, 用她们的心意，用她们的言语，一切的一切来服务 Krishna.
They came to this world justto be with Lord Krishna.
他们来到这个世界上的目的就是为了跟 Krishna 在一起。
We have to understand who are these gopis.
我们必须要理解一下这些 gopi 们都是谁。
Just like the cowherd boys, to get the position of a cowherd boy, they had to perform pious activities for many lifetimes.
就像是牧牛童们，他们想得到这种地位，必须生生世世的去做很多的虔诚活动。
And similarly for the gopis, there are different groups of gopis.
同样道理，对于 gopi 们来讲呢，是有不同群体的 gopi。
One group of gopis are the personified Vedas.
有一群 gopi 是伟大经典的人格化身。
Personified Vedas wanted to understand the Lord as a person.
伟达经典的人格化身想理解主作为一个人的特征。
Because the Vedas deal more with karma kanda activities and impersonalism, and they don't speak much about the personal aspect of the supreme truth.
因为伟达经典主要讲的是 karma kanda 的活动，以及至尊人格守神的这种非人格的方面。并没有太多的去提及到他的人格的方面。
So the personified Vedas, they came and they took birth in the family of the cowherd people in Vrindavan, and they became gopis so that they could see Lord Krishna's wonderful pastimes.
于是伟达经典的人格化身便投生在了 Vrindavan 的牧牛郎之家，投生成 gopi 们，这样他们就可以去见证到主 Krishna 的奇妙的逍遥时光。
Another group of gopis are the sages from the Dandakaranya forest. They had seen Lord Ramachandra and they desired to enjoy a conjugal love with Lord Ramachandra. But Lord Ramachandra told them that I cannot because I vowed only one wife.If you want to enjoy this conjugal love with me, then my next incarnation you should come.
另外的一群 gopi, 他们是 Dandakaranya 森林之中的圣人们。当他们看到主 Ramachandra 的时候，就对他产生了情侣之爱。但是主 Ramachandra 告诉他们说，现在我不能达成你们的愿望，是因为在这一世的化身之中，我答应只娶一个妻子。
So the sages of Dandakaranya, they all took birth in the family of the cowherd people in Vrindavan, and they became gopis, and they were able to enjoy pastimes with Lord Krishna.
于是丹达卡拉耶森林之中的圣人们在主 Krishna 显现的时候，都同生在了这些牧牛郎之家，成为了牧牛姑娘 gopi 们，这样他们就可以跟 Krishna 一起享受逍遥时光。
Some other gopis come from the spiritual world. They've come down from the spiritual world just to be with Krishna.
还有一些牧牛姑娘们，她们直接来自于灵性世界，她们降临的目的就是为了跟 Krishna 在一起。
And you have other gopis who are just coming to the perfect stage. They're taking their final birth in this world, and they'll take part in Krishna's pastimes and then go back to God.
还有一些牧牛姑娘，这些 Gopi 们是刚刚达到完美，这将是他们在物质世界之内的最后一生。他们来加入 Krishna 之后呢，他们再跟 Krishna 一起回灵性世界。
So they're all very great souls.
他们都是非常伟大的灵魂。
And they're but they want to in to take part to give pleasure to Krishna in his pastimes.
他们都想参与到 Krishna 的逍遥时光之中，为 Krishna 带来快乐。
And they get more pleasure.Because they make great sacrifices for Krishna.
而他们得到更多的快乐，是因为他们为 Krishna 做出了巨大的牺牲。
And because they're sacrificing for Krishna, they're experiencing more ecstasy.
因为他们为 Krishna 付出了巨大的牺牲，所以他们感觉到更多的喜乐，更多的狂喜。
And Krishna wants to experience that pleasure himself.
Krishna 也想自己体验一下这种喜乐。
Therefore, he came as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
这是为什么他作为主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 到来。
So that he can also taste that happiness which they are having.
这样呢，他也可以体验到他们所感受到的这种快乐。
So that this is the confidential reason for the appearance of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
这就是主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 显现的机密原因。
And the external reason was to establish the Yuga Dharma.
而外在的原因是为了确立 Yuga Dharma.
The chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra, the Sankirtan movement.
也就是唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra, Sankirtan 运动。
But the confidential reason was to taste the nectar of Radha Bhav, the love which Srimati Radharani had.
但机密的原因是为了品味 Radha Bhav， 也就是 Srimati Radharani 的情感。
And Krishna wants to experience.
Krishna 想去体验一下。
It said Radha and Krishna are one, but they separated themselves. But then, when they came as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they again became one.
据说 Radha Krishna 原本是一体，但是他们又永恒地分开了。然后当主 Chaitanya 降临的时候呢，他们又合二为一。
Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you see, Shri Krishna Chaitanya, Radha Krishna, Nahi Anya. That Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is not different from the combined form of Radha and Krishna.
因为我们说主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 跟 Radha Krishna 的结合体没有区别。
He is Krishna, but he has come in the mood of Srimati Radharani.
他是 Krishna， 但是他是以 Srimati Radharani 的情感到来的。
Because he wants to taste that bliss, that pleasure of conjugal love.
因为他想去品味，想去体验这种情侣之爱的风味。
And he has to come as a devotee to do that.
他必须要以奉献者的身份来才能做到。
If he's always Krishna, he's just the object of worship.
如果他一直保持 Krishna 的身份，那他就只能是成为崇拜的对象。
He wants to experience the pleasure of being in the giving the love, offering the love.
但是他想去体验一下，你去供奉爱是什么样的感受。
And that is even greater than the pleasure which Krishna gives.
而这个甚至超过 Krishna 所能够体验到的快乐。
Probably another question. This one.
Hare Krishna, Dear Guru, Dear Sunita Fungyanja. Guru 早上刚讲课说，就是我们这些奉献者都是来索取的哈，就是见到 Guru 都想，让 Guru 敲敲头、关关顶，就是消除自己的业障。我们这种想法。是不是不对呀、啊？给雇主增加业报，是不是我们用心一顶脉，不用直接出脉，是一样的吗？还是不是
？My question is actually everyone of us would like to take instead of giving. For example, we like to take blessings from guru. We hope we can touch our head and give us blessings. But is this mentality correct or wrong? Maybe we should just pay obeisances in our minds and not to disturb you.
Well, it's the duty of devotees to give blessings.
奉献者的职责就是给出祝福。
And if you want the blessing of Krishna consciousness, that's not wrong.
如果你想要得到 Krishna 知觉的祝福，没有什么错误。
We all want that blessing.
我们都想要这样的祝福。
So, there's no wrong in your part if you want the blessings for Krishna consciousness.
如果你想要得到 Krishna 知觉的祝福，你这方面没有任何错误。奉献者的职责就是要给出祝福。
But the blessings must be Krishna
conscious. 但是这个祝福必须是 Krishna 知觉的。
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would always bless people. Krishnar Matir Vastu. May your mind always be on Krishna.
主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 总是祝福别人 Krishnar Matir Vastu. 愿你的心意一直处在 Krishna 知觉之中。
So we bless you.
我们祝福你们。
Always remember Krishna.
我们祝福你们永远记住 Krishna。
Never forget Krishna。
永远不要忘记 Krishna。
Okay.
Okay.
And the last question from Prabhu from Kaipita.
Yadavraj Prabhu has a question.
Hare Krishna Maharaj. Maharaj, this actually is not a question, but it's a humble request.
它其实不是一个问题，是一个卑微的请求。
Maharaj, there's a death sentence inmate. He was is practicing Krishna bhakti now with his family.
有一个被判死刑的人，他跟他的家人一起在修习 Krishna 知觉。
Today he's going for the final court appeal.
今天他要进行最后一次的法庭上诉。
In few hours time, the judge will give a verdict for his appeal.
然后在几个小时之内，法官会对他做出一个最终极的审判。
So if he's given 30 years, he has to spend another 7 years in prison.
他已经待了三十年，他还要在监狱里要待七年。
If he's given 20 years, he has to spend until end of the year only.
就是说他如果要是能得到一个就是改判那个判成三十年如果要是改判的话有一种可能性就是说他要服刑他已经服了三十年的刑他还再服七年那如果再减刑的话呢就只需要再服二十年的刑那他就可以刑满释放了
Yes, he's practicing Krishna Bhakti and has taken shelter from his ordinance Jayapata Goswami Maharaj.
他一直在休息亏损的知觉已经脱壁了生活家帕塔克斯瓦米马哈拉。
So he has requested the devotees to pray to Srimati Radharani for blessing so that he'll have a favorable wording from the judge.
然后他就想祈祷奉献者们今天向 Srimati Radharani 祈祷然后今天让这个法官给他做出一个最后的有力的判决。
Thank you very much.
非常感谢大家。
Okay, Hare Krishna, thank you all very much. Hare Krishna, Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai. Shri Shri Radhastami Mahotsava ki jai. Jai Jai Shri Radhe.
Shalom. I have two announcements to make. So first of all, I would like to thank His Holiness Bhaktivinoda Vinod Narasimha Swami Maharaj for his wonderful class.
我有两件事情要宣布。首先，我要非常的感谢圣宗巴蒂维的米纳什纳西和马哈拉什非常精彩的讲课。
Secondly, I would like to welcome the new arrival devotees. I know that within the last 3 days, how many devotees have come to Malaysia?
其次呢，我想欢迎所有刚刚到马来西亚的这些奉献者，在过去的两三天之内，多少人来了？你举手，就昨天、前天来的，举下手。
No, you came long before.
不是说之前，就之前来过的不算，就是刚到马来西亚。
Okay, a few, you see. Especially, would like to welcome a very senior Vaishnavi, very senior disciple of Tamal Krishna Maharaj, Chitra Vilasini Mataji, from Hong Kong.
我们尤其的要特别的欢迎一位圣座塔玛拉克什纳高斯瓦米的资深门徒，来自于香港的 Chitra Vilasini Mataji.
I noticed also when Mataji came yesterday and today, just for one day, and then he's going back to China, just coming for one day only.
我知道还有一个 Mataji, 那个麦粒儿，你可以举手吗？他昨天来，今天就要走了。
This is how, you see, very touching to see how much devotees, how much they appreciate devotee association just to come here for one day.
所以这是非常令人感动的一件事情。你得有多么的珍惜跟奉献者的联谊啊！所以你就只待了一天也来了。
And I noticed a few devotees they have gone back to China.A few days ago, and again they came back. About 10 of you, they came back. So thank you for coming back.
那么我还知道有几个奉献者呢，就差不多不到十天之前，你们回到了中国，然后你们又回来了。
Some devotees they told me they have some gifts they can bring for His Holiness the Pataka Swami. If you have done, no need to give to any secretary. Maybe we try to arrange to give it personally to him tonight. You can give it to him tonight.
我知道有一些奉献者给就是准备了礼物给圣座迦帕塔克斯瓦米 Maharaj. 你们不要给任何其他的人，不用给秘书，自己留着。我会努力为大家安排一次机会，让你们亲自的去交给 Maharaj.
Today is a very special day.To remember him because in the Radhashtami day, today, when he was just 21 years old, he took sannyasi initiation from Srila
Prabhupada.
So, and today's program.Supposed to start at 10, but we're going to have a 15-minute break, and we will be having bhajans here in the temple. We will be singing for the pleasure of Radha Syam Sundara.
我们本来应该接下来的节目10点开始，但是为了大家方便，我们稍微休息15分钟。我们会在这里为了取悦 Radha Syam Sundara 进行 kirtan.
And then again, we're going to have 10-minute break.